Welcome to Trinity Lutheran Church. Today we celebrate the baptism of our Lord Jesus Christ. But first, a couple of announcements. The tidings deadline is actually next Sunday. When you see the announcements later on in the service, you will read that it says today is the deadline. My bad. But it's good for you, because then it will give you a few more days to prepare that article for the newsletter if you were going to do so. The second announcement is that beginning next week, we ask that you have your Bible close by so that you can follow when the readers read scripture. The words will not be printed as they have in the past. And so, we use the NRSV translation if you want to follow along word for word, or you can just close your eyes and listen quietly as each word is spoken. It's a beautiful way to breathe in the Word of God. Let us take a moment now to prepare our hearts and minds for worship while we listen to the prelude.
As I went down in the river to pray, studying about that good old way, and who shall wear the starry crown, good Lord, show me the way. Oh, sisters, let's go down, come on down. Oh, sisters, let's go down, down in the river to pray. As I went down in the river to pray, studying about that good old way, and who shall wear the robe and crown, good Lord, show me the way. Oh, brothers, let's go down, come on down. Come on, brothers, let's go down, down in the river to pray. As I went down in the river to pray, studying about that good old way, and who shall wear the starry crown, good Lord, show me the way. Oh, fathers, let's go down, come on down. Oh, fathers, let's go down, down in the river to pray.
Blessed be the Holy Trinity, one God whose voice is upon the waters, whose mercy is poured out upon all people, whose goodness cascades over all creation. Amen. Let us confess our sins, trusting in the abundant grace of God. God of goodness and loving kindness, we confess that we have sinned against you and our neighbors. We have turned away from your invitation to new life. We have turned away from the lowly and downtrodden. In your abundant mercy, forgive us our sins, those we know and those known only to you, for the sake of the one who came to live among us, Jesus Christ, our Savior. Amen.
How vast is God's grace! The voice of the Lord is powerful and it is full of splendor. Through the power, our sins are washed away by the promise of Christ Jesus, and we are claimed as God's beloved. Indeed, we are forgiven. In the wake of God's forgiveness, we are called to be the beloved community, living out Christ's justice and the Spirit's reconciling peace. Holy God, creator of light and giver of goodness, your voice moves over the waters. Immerse us in your grace and transform us by your Spirit, that we may follow after your Son, Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, now and forever. Amen.
We fall down, we lay our crowns at the feet of Jesus, the greatest of mercy and love, at the feet of Jesus. And we cry, holy, 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 and we cry, holy, 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 and we cry, holy, holy, holy is the Lamb.
Genesis chapter 1, verses 1 through 5. In the beginning, when God created the heavens and the earth was a formless void, and darkness covered the face of the deep, while a wind from God swept over the face of the waters. Then God said, "Let there be light," and there was light. And God saw that the light was good, and God separated the light from the darkness. God called the light day, and he called the darkness he called night. And there was evening, and there was morning, the first day. Word of God, word of life.
The reading of Psalm 29. Ascribe to the Lord, you gods. Ascribe to the Lord glory and strength. Ascribe to the Lord the glory due God's name. Worship the Lord in the beauty of holiness. The voice of the Lord is upon the waters. The God of glory thunders. The Lord is upon the mighty waters. The voice of the Lord is a powerful voice. The voice of the Lord is a voice of splendor. The voice of the Lord breaks the cedar trees. The Lord breaks the cedars of Lebanon. The Lord makes Lebanon skip like a calf, and Mount Hermon like a young wild ox. The voice of the Lord burst forth in lightning slashes. The voice of the Lord shakes the wilderness. The Lord shakes the wilderness of Kadesh. The voice of the Lord makes the oak trees writhe and strips the forest bare. And in the temple of the Lord, all are crying, glory. The Lord sits enthroned above the flood. The Lord sits enthroned as King forevermore. O Lord, give strength to your people. Give them, O Lord, the blessings of peace.
Jesus came to Jordan to be baptized by John. He did not come for pardon, but as the sinless one. He came to share repentance with all who mourn their sins, to speak the vital sentence with which good news begins. He came to share temptation, our utmost woe and loss, for us and our salvation, to die upon the cross. So when the dove descended on him, the Son of vows we made, this very day in aid us, and every bondage break. Come, give our lives direction, the gift we covet most, to share the resurrection that leads to Pentecost.
Gospel according to Mark, the first chapter. John the Baptizer appeared in the wilderness, proclaiming a baptism of repentance for the forgiveness of sins. And people from the whole Judean countryside and all the people of Jerusalem were going out to him and were baptized by him in the river Jordan, confessing their sins. Now John was clothed with camel's hair, with a leather belt around his waist, and he ate locusts and wild honey. He proclaimed, "The one who is more powerful than I is coming after me. I am not worthy to stoop down and untie the thong of his sandals. I have baptized you with water, but he will baptize you with the Holy Spirit." In those days, Jesus came from Nazareth of Galilee and was baptized by John in the Jordan. And just as he was coming up out of the water, he saw the heavens torn apart and the Spirit descending like a dove on him. And a voice came from heaven, "You are my Son, the Beloved. With you I am well pleased." The Gospel of our Lord.
Imagine the voice of God speaking to you. What do you suppose that would sound like? Perhaps as the psalmist proclaims, thunder and lightning, which breaks the trees and shakes deserts. Or perhaps it's a whisper, as gentle as a calming summer breeze. Can God's voice rip trees up by their roots and soothe the gentle soul? The answer is yes. God's presence and his voice, however, is less noted by his voice and more often as his breath, like that of a descending dove. The Bible defines the breath of God beginning in the very first sentence. God's breath is the Holy Spirit sweeping over the face of the waters. God's breath gives life to humanity. Before Jesus ascended into heaven, God breathed on the disciples. And 2 Timothy 3:16 proclaims that all scripture is God-breathed. That is why it is so important to read the Bible. You never know what is waiting for you as God's breath rises up from those pages into your nostrils and into your heart and minds. On this special day, we witness the baptism of our Lord, and we cannot help but remember our own baptism and how we received the second breath of life. You see, when we enter this world, we take our first breath, the sign of life. Think of it this way, the breath of God literally resides inside each one of us, our entire life. Our second breath then comes at baptism as we breathe in forgiveness and breathe out the Spirit of God. Jesus promises not only to forgive and protect, but he promises to bring light midst darkness. Through his grace and mercy, his light overcomes the shadows of doubt, the gloom and doom of life, and it will never go out. How we share this light is up to us. We can use it for good, or we can be what Paul calls lukewarm, with a low burning light. This reminds me of something I heard this past week in a conversation between two American journalists. Harry Smith said that in all his travels across America, he sensed most people go about their lives without much concern. about what else is going on in the world. That they have enough to deal with right in their backyards. Savannah Guthrie felt that people have a responsibility, that it is their duty to be informed, so they can make a difference. Well, this was a light bulb moment for me. I saw similarities between their conversation and the condition of the church. There is a good portion of people in the church who just go about their business. Job, family, financial woes, health issues, the normal day-to-day struggles mixed in with fleeting moments of escape whenever one can get away from it all. Most everyone has enough on his or her plate without worrying about the church. They might attend worship, give offerings, and even participate in some of the church events. And they may not always know what is happening behind the scenes, which I never considered to be a bad thing, really, for two reasons. One, they may not think about the church much, except on Sunday mornings, but at least they are thinking about church. And two, they trust the decision makers. This could be a blessing. I mean, over the 9.5 years that I have been here, there has been very little discord. I took it that people were content, you know, calm waters with very little waves of trouble. And that's a good thing, right? Well, now I have to wonder if contentment is good enough. I wonder if status quo shines bright enough into the world. Is sitting in church behind closed doors 1 hour a week, or currently in the comfort of your homes, worshiping God, enough? Can we do more with our hands and feet, our voices, our creative minds, and our dollars? It doesn't mean that we all do everything, but it does mean everything we do fulfills all our mission for God. The lyrics in the Christian song, which we will hear later on, "He shall reign forevermore," reminds us of our baptismal promise. If I were a wise man, I would travel far. If I were a shepherd, I would do my part. I think we can all shine a little brighter. Breathe in the words of Scripture and breathe out the work of the Holy Spirit. Flood the nations with grace and mercy. No more lukewarm. It is our duty to be Christ-like with every breath we take. May the Spirit of God breathe into our hearts the desire. May the Spirit of God set our hearts on fire. Amen.
Shine, Jesus, shine. Fill this land with the Father's glory. Blaze, Spirit, blaze. Set our hearts on fire. Flow, river, flow. Flood the nations with grace and mercy. Send forth your word, Lord, and let there be light. Lord, the of the darkness shining. Jesus, light of the world, shine upon us. Set us free by the truth you now bring us. Shine on me. Shine on me. Shine, Jesus, shine. Fill this land with the Father's glory. Blaze, Spirit, blaze. Set our hearts on fire. Flow, river, flow. Flood the nations with grace and mercy. Send forth your word, Lord, and let there be light. As we gaze on your kingly brightness, slow our faces to slay your likeness, ever changing from glory to glory. Mirrored here, may our life tell your story. Shine on me. Shine on me. Shine, Jesus, shine. Fill this land with the Father's glory. Blaze, Spirit, blaze. Set our hearts on fire. Flow, river, flow. Flood the nations with grace and mercy. Send forth your word, Lord, and let there be light.
Guided by Christ, let us offer prayers for the church, the world, and all people in need. We pray for the church and its leaders, that guided by the Holy Spirit, we know that we are forgiven. We pray for the sick and those who provide medical care, for the imprisoned and those who show them mercy, for the lonely and those who provide companionship, for all who suffer, especially those we name in our hearts and on our lips, that God shower compassion upon them. We pray for the Trinity family, gathered here in spirit, for students returning to school, for those seeking renewal in their daily work or seeking gainful employment. We pray that all the beloved of God experience His grace and peace. In thanksgiving for the faithful departed who now rest from their labors, we pray that their witness inspire us in our baptismal callings. Merciful God, hear the prayers of your people, spoken or silent, for the sake of the one who dwells among us and speaks his voice to us and breathes into us. Your Son, Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. You are holy God.
Holy, 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 my heart, my heart adores you. My heart is glad to say the words, you are holy God. Thank you.
To love a stranger as a friend, compassion at a lonely end, finding a light for one in darkness, comfort those in pain, for the poor and dumb we show kindness, lost find a way. We offer all to God above our gifts of love.
O God, receive these gifts as you receive us, like a mother receives her child, with arms open wide. Nourish us anew in your tender care and empower us in faithful service to tend to others with this same love through Jesus Christ, our saving grace. Send your spirit of your Son into our hearts and onto this bread, that as your beloved children we may welcome our Savior who comes to us in his body and blood. In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread, gave thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." After supper, he took the cup, blessed it, and gave for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." Remembering therefore his preaching and healing, his dying and rising, and his promise to come again, we await that day when all the universe will rejoice in your holy and life-giving light. By your Spirit, bless us and this meal, that refreshed with this heavenly food, we may be light for the world, revealing the brilliance of your Son. Through him, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, with the Holy Spirit, in your holy church, both now and forever. Amen. Together, let us pray the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. Beloved, here is the bread, here is the wine, here is Jesus. Come and be fed. The body of Christ given for you, and the blood of Christ shed for you.
Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world. Grant us peace, grant us peace, O Lord. Grant us peace. Grant us peace, O Lord.
The body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ strengthen and preserve you in eternal life. Let us pray. Christ Jesus, at this table, we have feasted on your very life and are strengthened for our journey. Send us forth from this banquet, nourished in body and in spirit, to proclaim your good news, to be a light, to serve others in your name. Amen. Almighty God, who sent the Holy Spirit to Mary, proclaimed joy through the angels, sent the shepherds with good news, and led by the Magi by the star, bless you this day through the Word made flesh. Amen. Go in peace. Be the light of Christ. Thanks be to God.